Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build my fast 8x8 vault trapdoor, which you can see right in front of you. As you can see, at the moment it looks like a simple 8x8 chute that's going straight down with a lever to one side, and if I flick said lever, it closes up within just a few moments in a nice looking spiral sequence, and I'm left with this vault trapdoor design right there. Which, by the way, is not really replicated at the bottom, but it does look quite interesting anyway. So, continuing on, let's flick the lever once more. And as you can see, it also opens up really fast, and I am left with the straight chute again. So, that's basically what the Singer does. Now let's talk about the sizes. So it has a 16 by 16 footprint, and is 7 blocks high, 8 blocks if you count the actual floor. And the resources you're gonna need are in this chest here, so a lot of building blocks, then 56 obsidian blocks, 4 slabs, 36 slime blocks, 103 redstone dust, 39 redstone repeaters, 64 observers, so a full stack, then 32 or a half stack of pistons, 56 sticky pistons, 4 node blocks, 8 hoppers and a lever as an input, and maybe some additional redstone wiring to relocate the lever to where you can actually reach it. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need, so let's quickly show you how to build this trapdoor here. Okay, so the first step is figuring out the actual layout of the trapdoor, which as a reference point has this 2x2 of movable blocks at the very center, 4 blocks below the actual floor level. Then following that we have the 3 rings that are getting bigger towards the outside, and then, of course, we have the 4 wide floor in each direction. Furthermore, this door is symmetric, so we have essentially just one type of module, and that is built 4 times and rotated around the center, essentially. Which means that I will show you how to build this front module here, and then build the other modules during the cuts. Anyway, let's start with the module here. For that, we go to the very center, and start with this left one. From here we go down 3 blocks, then towards the outside another 3 blocks, and place an obsidian block. Then we can remove those blocks again. Now, towards the left side, if we are looking towards the center, we need 4 obsidian blocks going up, then another one towards this side. And on the right side we need first 3 blocks up, then 2 blocks out, and then another one diagonally like so. Then grab a normal block, place it right there, followed by another few going in a kind of circle as you can see there. Then a hopper raised here. Now we need a repeater on 2 ticks here and redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Following that, let's place another block down here with repeater on 4 ticks in this direction, running into a full block. Then 2 blocks up there, a layer above that, another 2 blocks here. Fifth one there, and a hopper on top of the repeater there. Then place down 4 redstone dust as you can see here, followed by a repeater on 4 ticks here and on 2 ticks there. Then on top of this redstone wire we need a normal piston in this direction. Following that, place down 2 blocks in there, then another 2 blocks here, redstone dust on top of all of them, block here to cut off that wire. Following that, an obsidian block right in front of that wire. Then don't forget the redstone wire down here. Next place 2 observers going upwards, as you can see here. Running into a full block with a upside down slab in this position. Running out of that is a repeater on 4 ticks. And that is running into a full block. Then let's go down here again. First we need a sticky piston on top of the wire, then in front of the wire, and then one layer above that, another 2 sticky pistons building a double piston extender. Now we place 4 slime blocks in a T-shape as you can see here, and then 2 normal blocks towards the front. The third one is already placed, and on top of that sticky piston we need a normal piston and another normal block, although this is already placed there. Now a quick correction. First remove this block in front of the repeater there, then replace it with an observer, and then we need the block behind the observer. Following that, place another observer on top of the repeater there, then place three observers going in a kind of circle, as you can see here. Another one right there. Put a block to the front of it, then place down two steel pistons there, two normal pistons on top, then two slime blocks to the front, and a normal block right there and here. And now let's give this half a little test run. So simply power this line down here with some redstone wire. And now those should extend. And if we unpower it, those parts should also retract and completely flatten out. Following that, let's go to this side here. First, we need another two blocks going up diagonally like so. Then towards the back, another two blocks there. Repeat on vortex here and redstone dust on top of those blocks. Then a raised block in this corner, redstone dust on top, an obsidian block here to cut off that wire. Then we need a normal piston in this corner facing downwards, right next to the redstone wire there. Following that, let's go and place a block here and another two blocks, as you can see there. Redstone dust here, repeat on two ticks there, redstone dust there. Then a row of three steel pistons with normal pistons on top and slime blocks to the front. And then normal blocks, as you can see here. Then let's give it another test run. And of course I forgot that block here, and now this should extend. And also retract, and this part will flatten out later on. Now for the last few steps, first place a block next to the redstone wire there, then we need two blocks with repeaters on four ticks each in this direction. Put an observer on top of the last repeater, another two observers to this side, running the full block of redstone wire on top. An observer looking at it from this side, then a node block there, with another observer in this direction. Then put an observer here, followed by a normal block and two more observers. Then four sticky pistons towards the front and another one on this side. And then place normal blocks in front of the repeaters. And then let's test the entire thing out. So it should come out, as you can see here. And if we unpower it, it should also completely flatten out again. So once you've built all four sides of the door, it's time to interconnect them. We start on one module and then connect the other three in a kind of chain reaction. For that, we go down here from this block, which is directly fed from the repeater there, and simply go out until we are in line with the edge of the next module. Go around until we reach this point here, then raise this block, put a repeater in this corner, and then just some redstone wire down there. So now those two modules are connected. Now we build the exact same thing once more. And then one final time. And with that, we are pretty much finished. So all you have to do is essentially power this redstone line here on the first module, and then everything closes up in a kind of circle. And of course opens up the same way. And with that, the last part is maybe relocating this lever to somewhere you can actually reach, and then of course fill in the rest of the walls and the floor with blocks. And voila! So with that, we have finally reached the end of this tutorial about my fast 8x8 volt trapdoor. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!